Hi, my name is Martinez, and you're watching Imagine TV. Usually when I get asked where I'm from, I have to think a little bit because it's been 5 years as I live in London. But obviously, yes, I am from Lithuania, and I'm really happy to be still Lithuanian, even though I live in London for quite a long time. And I studied in London as well. But the very beginning of my musical activity obviously started in Lithuania. I was 3 years old when I first encountered with some music, which was actually a piano concert on the TV. And I was really inspired, and then I wanted to play piano, but my family couldn't afford to buy one for me, so my uncle got an accordion instead for me. And I started playing it for around 4 years. I played it completely on my own without a teacher. And then when I was 8, I began going to the music school, which took me 10 years. And then I came to London 5 years ago. It's funny, when I started playing accordion, all I did was playing Lithuanian folk songs and singing along with myself. Really enjoyed that, but then when I went to the music school, I completely turned away from folk music background, and I was like, this is my new direction. I'm going for classical and modern original accordion music. And so I did, and when I came to London, I was even more into classical, but then my friends and colleagues brought me back to the folk music because they were interested to know what the Lithuanian folk music is like. What does it sound like? And we started experimenting on that music, on those themes. So I think the folk, and especially Lithuanian folk music, has a lot of influence on me. But also, I mean, I have been trained as a classical musician, so I've heard a lot of classical pieces, and I'm sure they had influences on me. But again, like, in the mornings, I can listen to some jazz, to some pop, so, you know, I have lots of different angles to be influenced by and inspired. I was always the only one doing that. But like in the music school in Lithuania, it was a huge group of people playing accordion. We also had an orchestra of accordions in there. But in London, when I came, I was the only one in my entire course playing accordion. And in total, we were 7 accordion players in academy studying this instrument. And when I left, we were only 3. So it's not a big amount, but at the same time, I think it's quite good because then you get more attention from your professor. He has a little bit more time for you. So that's great, but it would be great if there were a little bit more accordion players in London especially. I love playing Baroque, and I love listening to Baroque, especially early Baroque. But I also adore all the modern classical music which has been created in the past 100 years. And that is the most of the repertoire that I studied in academy, and it's the most enjoyable repertoire for me. It is quite common because we still have those music schools where children go after their main schools, either primary or secondary high school. So they go to the music school where they learn one instrument or several instruments and also music theory, oral and analysis and this and that. So I'm really happy about the situation because, you know, those schools are funded by the country, and you can get sort of a very cheap musical education, which can actually lead you to some kind of professional musical life, which was the case for me. And the cultural and musical life in Lithuania is becoming more and more active. In general, we get more super international stars coming and playing or singing. And also we have a few good orchestras and a few very good soloists. And mostly, obviously, as for every good artist, they travel around the world, and mostly they live somewhere else but not Lithuania, but then they come and make concerts. So it's great. I think it is a lot about luck, about being in the right place in the right time. It happened to me quite often in my life. But I think just talent is not enough. You have to work a lot. And even when you work and you can't see any result, you have to work even more. And I can see quite a few people around me, even in my friends' environment, that people sometimes give up too early. Because as I said, if you don't succeed, that means you have to go for even harder.